So, last year ended with kind of a bang.
So, my roommate is moving out right now on us. The one who signed the lease.
Legally, he has no right to do any of this.
I never said anything about him.
Everybody is going to believe whatever they want to believe.
Even Merwin and Nick and I had a falling out. I also had a fallout with Scott.
I'm not lying.
I found out people were calling me a player, and the rest is history.
He said, well, you play with guys' heads, and then you just move on.
It's been 6 months since all of that happened. Once again, it's New Year's, but it's definitely not the same as last year.
Yeah.
There we go. Ta-da!
This is Phil.
And also, a little.
It's the foreigner.
Thanks.
Hello.
That's Max, my date. We met a little while ago on Facebook. He's a pretty good catch. Or he would be if he wasn't about to end up spending the night in my bed with another guy.
Yeah, these people look of age.
Another year is gone, and thank God Zach is no longer in town. New year, new boys.
Except that kid.
Look at the dimples. Isn't he cute? Who's he boo?
Come on, that's kind of funny.
Oh, dude. Wait, we'll get like.
John Chris, do a shot. One, two, three, go!
Go! What should they do?
When they hands up,
didn't hang out for the longest time because of Brandon.
It's a wonder.
I know I'm being a douche, kind of like taking away from the party and stuff, but I really had to ask you something.
You're not lying.
I'm not lying to you.
You're not lying about what happened. I didn't want to not like you. I honestly didn't. People lied.
Lots of months.
That's okay. That's exciting. Yeah.
Okay.
You can touch me inappropriately.
Actually, I can't, but it's in my head. It's happening as we speak, actually. Hi, I'm Amy.
Nice to meet you. What's your name?
Michael.
Nice gonna forget you. It. Hi, guys.
So, at the end of last season, Zach is gone. Zach took off. I broke up with Dave, or Dave broke up with me. Whatever.
Okay, is this too trampy or does this work?
You know what, I'm just really happy that there's a group of girls here that I fucking don't hate.
You're really tall.
My level of attraction goes girls, gay boys, straight boys.
There was this new girl, Lexi, who seemed okay at first. She saw the videos and thought they were cool, and I guess felt like she like knew us already. It turned out she thought I was cool or something, and basically tried to steal my life.
I don't know why I'm more attracted to gay boys. I don't think it's because I can't have them. It's just
she started seeing Dave, which is not okay.
Woo! That wasn't awkward at all!
Ready? This is Nick.
Hello.
How's it going?
Hi, Nick.
I Facebook messaged Chris and decided it was about time that I met someone who was like me. I was like, oh, who is this guy? I scrolled down and then I saw the groups he was in. It was like, gay men who like Amy's boobs.
They left me. They went back to my house without me. I'm the host. Oh my god. Get out of my bed.
So, last summer, Zach left, moved to Vancouver, Dave broke up with me. Chris and I started hanging out a lot more than we ever have before.
Baby!
Baby!
Nick, you're on camera and you're gonna regret it.
Ow.
I'm gonna regret it.
Yeah. Chris, I'll kill you.
Chris, can we watch some of them
so,
later?
Oh my god, I'm already involved.
And we ended up going home and hanging out with like some people that we've never hung out with before, just randomly. It was kind of like everything was just new.
This thing freaks me out.
We've done this for so long now that we really actually like don't even care that it's there anymore. The first time when Scott was at my house, that was the first time I actually kind of felt comfortable.
You know, see, that's why I said I gotta be a little drunk.
Because I hated it at first, and then I saw myself on camera, and I was like, this is fun.
Why do you have a fish in a...
Sure.
Okay, so we're about to go to my birthday party. I'm so stoked.
What did you even do?
Ow, I just got spanked.
There's a camera.
This is how we party. This has been the best birthday ever.
Don't hate. We'll Cody throw you off the balcony because that's here. How us Rutland.
Can you faggot? Cody. If Cody wasn't gay, I would sex him all over.
I'm not that drunk.
You better not.
You're exhausted.
Hey.
Can't wait.
Like fights.
Retarded people are.
The room is occupied.
Is there anything such as a mild mannered lesbian or what?
I think girls are more attractive, but I always seem to end up with guys.
Yeah, no, I find guys more attractive than girls. However, I find females attractive.
You want a trophy?
So basically, Gotch just fucking sucks and never do is pissed off at everybody.
Well, so drama. Like, I just wish that everybody would just not be like that. That's why I've been, like, not hanging out as much. I've been kind of trying to, like, find the, like, less dramatic crowd.
Believe it or not, that would be us.
What? We're less dramatic?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm just glad I'm not there right now.
Okay, well, I have a staff meeting at 10, and then I'll call you after that. Just as long as you don't fucking talk about Dave at all. Good, let's just everybody fucking talk about David!
What would happen?
Who cares? Let's go drink more.
Guys, I'm a little off from anything.
Let the owners of the house go.
Cops are here.
Answer the door! Please,
it's the cops.
Yeah, but
you have to answer.
You know what? Cop can't enter the house. And you're of age now. Just sit and just mellow.
Where's the alcohol?
Cops are here everywhere.
You guys! Everybody relax.
Okay, everybody! Tune it down! Relax!
Cops cannot enter the house.
Here,
and I'm like, it's my sister's birthday party, and they're like, okay, you guys gotta quiet down because it's 11. I'm like, okay.
What happened?
We just turned it
down. Chris and I got wasted one night, just the two of us, which is actually really fun. We'd never done that before.
But I... And it still can't. It's this is silly. It's just us.
Yeah, and that ended up being one of those random drunken nights where you kind of have like a bonding moment, but instead of like drunkenly forgetting it, it like sticks forever.
Can we do my hair later?
I'm gonna make you look like Lauren Conrad.
Do you see what's happening right now? We're like besties.
We're friends.
We were kind of friends before, but like only like sometimes. I like your eyebrows.
And we ended up, he was like telling me all about this Will guy, who seemed like a cool guy. And drunkenly, we ended up calling him because that seemed like the right thing to do at the time.
I'm gonna show you the guy I've been talking to in Vancouver. He's like the manager of Odyssey, a club, which is crazy. I had no idea.
Click on that picture. He's ripped.
I know. He's so pretty.
He's so pretty.
And this is when he's, like, dressed up as, like, an anime character.
So does he cute. Go to, like, Comic-Cons and stuff? He yeah. can, he'll love me, right?
Of course he will.
Especially tonight.
But do you actually want to, like, go to Vancouver?
As long as he actually wants me to come.
What? He's so nice, I told you.
And after Chris finally convinced me that he did actually like me. Yeah, it didn't take much. For Chris to convince me that we needed to go, considering Will was going to pay for our flights, let us stay at his gorgeous place for free, and he also happened to be the manager at one of the gay clubs in Vancouver, therefore free cover, free drinks, free everything. We got flown to Vancouver to party.
Oh good. That's
hey.
Awesome. It was just me and you last night. We were so drunk. We're the biggest losers
ever. That was a wild party.
Vancouver Airport is like right on the water. Like, what if we like overshoot it or undershoot it and then we're dead?
Huge elevator.
That's because people have baggage.
I guess you live on the other side of the airport or something. Public transport, does that mean?
We have to go back up after.
Don't know where to go.
In front to Yale Town.
Moment to say that we're here for the Olympics. I think it's gonna be pretty crazy.
Canadians are making assholes of themselves.
hospitable. He shows us around his beautiful place. He had to leave like right away. He gives us a key and just like tells us to, you know, hang out. Here's my liquor. Can you imagine how it's gonna be tomorrow? If we win the Olympics and we like win the hockey game, I think there would be a riot.
We're at Will's house. We're right downtown, we're right across from, you know where that they're playing all that music, that free music? We're gonna head to the O and then we're just gonna be there all night.
You look like sex on the beach. And I wanna be on you, big boy. I can't believe we're at Will's house in Vancouver, sorry.
It's weird, it's actually happening.
We have so much fun today.
Just keep
listen to the screaming. Oh, shitty. Oh my god!
I feel so patriotic right now. Oh my god!
Good thing we didn't go to the club yet.
Yeah. Oh, we've done this before.
Girl. Oh, we totally have done this before.
Yeah.
Have a couple drinks, and by a couple drinks, I mean like an ass load of drinks.
In the mirror?
I don't know.
Some of you, you're like a parakeet. So.
We're going to club now, love you, bye!
We're going to the gay world.
No, I can't kiss you for real.
Get to the club. Chris and Amy were here like on Will's list. And like, I didn't even have to check the list. It was just like, oh yeah, you guys want it. We were wasted. We have no idea how we got back.
Hey, Misha Barton.
Fuck you in your video. You wanna try you?
Wanna see these? They're called shoes.
Those shoes are called fucking held up at the fucking airport.
But this is what happened.
Did we go the wrong way?
No. Yeah, we did. We have to go back that way.
Was it your fault? Chris.
Good job, Canada. I'm stoked on this right now. We were outside videotaping the fireworks last night, and there was actually like big like burning embers like falling right in front of us. We were like, holy shit, this is
we're
dangerous.
Really goes on that way.
Yeah,
so
not
being under it. Let the looting begin.
Yes! We ended up going for breakfast and being screamed at by crazy Canadian fans because Canada won or whatever it was in hockey.
Jesus Christ.
I hate this so much.
Vancouver has gone crazy. He's so lucky that he lives in like such a nice place and he has like this awesome view of like. Hooray for hauling my ass all the way to Vancouver to fucking sit on the couch and not even go out.
But you're having fun.
You're right.
It's supposed to be Vancouver's busiest day.
There's nobody here.
Even the guy that was working here, we asked where we're supposed to go, and he's like, yeah, it's been really dead here all day. Awesome. Busiest day of the year.
Today was the busiest the airport has ever been. So busy, the airport authority added an auxiliary.
So Scott has finally met a boy that he likes, and more importantly, we like.
I'm James. I'm dating Scott now.
The only problem with James is Evan.
I dated Evan for about 8 months, and that didn't end up turning out very well in the end. We're okay now, I guess. So Kai wanted to hang out tonight, so I asked if I could bring a few people.
Kai, are you never had like a craving for like chocolate icing?
Yeah.
straight liquor. Just like, drink what?
Go out to parties, sit she within 2 sips of vodka, straw, good to go. I met James in high school, and we met at grad kidnapping. So the first day I ever saw him, he was in a pink corset.
Kai is definitely a keeper.
What?
Love Kai. Anyone who has an eye patch.
I am Kai. I get a random text today just, Scott and I are going out. You're like the first person I've told. Like before, I hadn't met Scott until like a week ago, and I heard Scott's name I don't know how many times before that.
Yes. Hi, love you all. It's me. From upstairs. I feel like a douchebag. Is that Cody?
I'm so drunk.
How are you, James?
I'm actually pretty good. How about Scott?
Do you like him?
Yeah. We actually met Scott on Manhunt, actually.
Do you see you two being like an item?
I would like to see that, so. Like, I've invited him to like a bunch of movies, and like, we both took each other out for dinner once.
Right. Well, how do you feel about that situation with your ex?
Evan has all the right to feel how he feels, but just the way he goes about expressing it, I think is over the top.
But you two are still like good friends.
We're trying to be, like he said today to me multiple times, like, I can't be your friend anymore because if you're in a relationship with Scott.
Like, yeah, but you know, I've heard that line before, and he'll still want to be your friend.
I got some lightness. Drunk with lesbians and Scott and Dave, and I woke up with orange hair.
Orange hair?
Yeah, I had to re-dye it to this color.
Okay. How orange was it?
Orphan Annie. No, next person that passes out, though, we'll give them a perm.
Well, I'm not sure. Drinking with you.
Let's make sure it's Cody.
I have to walk to work now.
Successful black man.
Have a nice light.
Now, sorry. He's dating Scott. But Evan always bitches about like not being invited out anywhere and
how. Well, invite him then, yeah.
No! He whines!
It's a really hard breakup when one person accepts that and the other one doesn't. The longer you hang on, the longer you go without a life, without air, and you start to turn crazier and crazier.
Cody, doesn't this sound familiar?
No, who?
Duel.
Oh.
I had to go through it, so. Good luck, Evan.
Who's all coming?
So far, it's just Cody, Amy, Nick, Evan, I think.
Evan and Amelia.
It's James. So, remember Chris's house?
I think you should come on over again.
See, there you are.
Okay, now we're gonna be best friends, okay?
There.
Okay, I see.
You're in there now.
Okay.
Hello.
So, Scott is coming here. I hope so.
Do you think it's gonna be awkward with Evan?
Maybe for a bit.
We're gonna do shots when Little Jack gets here.
He was calling me, but he thought he was talking to you.
Yeah.
But like, James can't suffer the wrath of Evan. He's like,
I can't believe he's going to get Evan. You know what? I'm gonna play the I'm a bitch and I don't care card tonight.
Oh, if he's gonna act like a dick. If he's gonna be a good one and try to give you and James some space, then he won't.
Is everything gonna be okay?
I don't know.
You're not mad at him already, though, are you?
I'm not mad at him already. I'm gonna give him a chance.
Okay, good.
But I'm just not gonna be very nice if he blows that chance.
Because, I mean, he is trying, I think.
Ish. He's trying-ish. I'm totally all down for them being friends.
No, I didn't get 4 2-liters of Coke.
6, 2, 4, 1, now the countdown!
Like, the first time I met you, and I'd see like every episode of Valley, which was 3 then.
They were obsessed with it.
I was obsessed!
Amelia and James were like obsessed.
We would watch it and I knew everybody's names. And then I went to a party at your house and I met everybody and it was like the best day of my life.
Was that
and I went to work the next day and I was like, oh my god, I was like, I met everybody from the Valley. And they were like, what's the Valley? I was like, that gay thing I told you about.
Well, like, with okay, James.
Look at me. I ignored basically all my friends.
Walking down the hall at one point in time, and then, because I saw Kate and Amelia in the bathroom, and then I heard Evan talking about our relationship and a burning a bunch of bridges.
I was just like, but yeah, it was fun. And then I dated James, and I was just like all focused on that and him and whatever. And basically just ditched everything. And I burnt a lot of bridges.
I'm Barbie.
Burnt a lot of bridges.
I'm Barbie a little bit.
So I just awkwardly turned around and skipped away.
And now,
there, Barbie.
And now I'm trying, now I'm trying to get back to that point.
It's my fault.
How is it your fault?
It is.
No.
James tried to, like, be affectionate earlier, and I'm like, no, I don't want to be a dick. Evan's here.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I'm not that kind of person.
That's her out.
Yeah.
I'm confused.
I'm not really. No, it's fine.
Is this gonna be anywhere that.
This like song. Chris, you have to hear this song.
I look like Lady Gaga.
Come.
And I don't know how
I love this song!
It. But you know what? She's not an attractive person.
I don't really care. Well, I mean, he might have left because of me. He might think it's awkward. He's dating my ex-boyfriend. I haven't talked to him at all about it, actually. He won't really talk to me.
What happened?
I don't know. I was just spending a lot of time with Brandon, and the whole thing between you and Brandon just kind of exploded, and I couldn't deal with that. I just had to just stop. I smile a lot, and every time you smile, anger gets bottled up deep inside of me.
It's a little intense.
I was watching Series 1, and it's true.
I'm glad we're speaking again.
So, past 6 months, things exploded, and now they've all sort of come down again. I kind of verbally punched Chris in the face. But now we're friends again. I've met Dave. We're seeing each other, I guess. It's nothing's official. He doesn't like being owned by someone. I don't know. I'm excited but worried at the same time. So yeah, because we're having it the hardest, right? The mm-hmm. golf club. We have the whole place, which is pretty awesome. You don't help making me so worried. Just over $7,000. And $20 plus in all the food they're getting.
Yeah.
We have the DJ and all the like the cake and stuff like that, which is so much more than we had at the boat last year. And people didn't seem to mind paying $25. And we got two free drinks.
The bar.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's no food. Drinks. Yeah, we got two drinks.
You want to go to somebody's birthday if you actually talk to them? If they don't talk to you for 4 months and they just kind of hide out?
Like, especially for the amount, $30 for a party?
And yeah, I haven't got like a text from either of them for at least 4 months.
I can understand not getting a text from Merwin. He works and he goes to school.
Everybody else works though too.
What?
Yeah. He could just be like, hey, how's it going? Haven't talked to you in a while. Like, you don't have to be like, oh, let's hang out or something. Usually when you want people to come to your party, you're, like, excited about it and, like, you talk to them about it and stuff. You don't
They're
just
probably talking
like,
to people, just not us.
Not us, yeah. They just feel like they already have us. Like, they're entitled to us already.
Have you met anyone yet? Have you met Cody yet? Have you met people? Nola? And we're outside having a picnic.
So Amy and I, we were really close. We got really close when she broke up with Dave. But now her and Dave kind of started hanging out again. And
David and I ended up hanging out together again more than was expected, and ended up starting to see each other again even after everything that happened. I kind of disappear from the world again, which I'm known for when I'm in a relationship, so my bad.
So it wasn't cool that while all Amy's friends were there for her during the rough patch, then all of a sudden Dave takes her back and
She's gone.
Yeah. I got mad for Chris, because I'm like, Chris was there pretty much every single day that Amy wanted someone to hang out with.
Yeah.
And then as soon as things get better between them, she pieces out and she doesn't even bother to give the phone call or even like a, hey, let's hang out. Oh, I'm busy right now. She doesn't even bother making up a lie.
No, just doesn't answer. Never texts you back. Before or after, if you want to hang out, Saturday.
Jonathan gets off at 70 sets.
So Jonathan is this cute, nice boy that I met first at the center. I guess he was more interested in Cody than me because Cody swooped right in and...
So Superman had kryptonite.
mine is red. Ginger's our slight weakness. Pretty little geeky ginger. Geek hunter.
Did I meet him before?
We went out the center. Pretty little ginger.
A ginger. Mm-hmm. Now I know where you're going off with this.
So, tell me about Saturday. What happened with you and James?
I had a conversation with Evan over dinner because I was trying to help him deal with the Scott situation. Trying to explain to him, but you need to keep your emotions in check. You're not going to have any friends left.
I didn't see Scott most of the night. It just seems like if Scott just decides to hate me or like not like me, that I would think that if Scott like truly hated me, that the relationship wouldn't last long.
And it's hard, like, because you have to see James with someone. Mm-hmm. And that's like where you used to be. And then it's,
oh, yeah.
Scott is already like on the defensive, like with you, because he feels like you're going to be like cause problems. And
I don't want to be like that.
Yeah, you don't want to be that, the crazy ex.
No. Well, because James said like if Scott ever like was like, you can't hang out with Evan or something, he'd be like, well, no, I'm gonna hang out with Evan still, he's my friend. And I don't think Scott would do that though. I think Scott's a nice guy. I think he's just upset over a mistake I made and that we can get past it.
Over it.
Evan's known for when he drinks, he gets emotional, and he's also known for not being able to hold his liquor.
He must have thought I was, like, being, like, really rude to him or standoffish or something, but, like, really, how do you want me to act in that kind of situation?
And, like, I've told Evan, like, I understand, like, how you feel. It's just how you're going about things and...
Mm-hmm. Oh, so Cody was telling me about his new boy.
Jonathan?
Jonathan Pretty. Yeah, I don't know. I'm definitely a little bit jealous of that one.
Are you?
Because I met him first, and I thought he was, like, super cute and, like, so nice. Except I'm, like, I'm not as forceful as Cody. So Cody just, like, goes in there and is, like, texting him all the time, and I'm like, shit.
Turns out a great technique for meeting guys is going up and talking to them and not being a pussy. So go up. I went up, asked him for his number.
It's not official yet. For the amount of people that Cody slept with that I liked, it's fair game.
Remember his first date with Tim? He's even cuter than Chris. I've met a boy and he's even cuter than Chris. This line is kind of getting old. Yeah.
Everyone else is just like, thanks.
I'm like, I'm gonna have to see this guy. So whatever, you could do
so much better. Have you seen Sherlock Holmes yet?
That was so cute.
So cute. Gigantically blatant gay subtext. I was like, I need a Watson. I want a Watson. And then someone messaged me back saying that he'd be my Watson.
Jonathan?
You're so cute!
So how much have you been texting Jonathan?
Several hundred messages.
Like, you were into that whole mushy-gushy.
I'm not into mushy-gushy. I'm not like ooey-gooey. That annoys me. Do you not agree with me on that?
Well, you like just met this guy like a week ago.
I know.
Not even a week ago yet, actually.
Creative. He's funny. He's a little bit vulgar. That's interesting.
Yeah. There's just one problem. He's not damaged.
I know. What if I liked a well-balanced guy? No offense.
None taken.
Holy shit. That does say condoms for rent.
Sorry. I'm gonna blame it on Chris.
Cool.
Cody was being all like playing with Jonathan's hair and like, and I'm kind of sitting across the table watching it all.
We'll drive. We can drive.
What's this Ebenezer?
Secondhand store. I'm gonna look for Sega games.
Me.
Awesome, thank you.
Hello, my name is Jonathan. I'm an actor. Big surprise there, almost all the video bloggers on the internet are actors. I work at Boston Pizza. My life is pretty exciting. I guess.
Yeah.
Hey guys.
The trip was fun. I was really nervous. Really, really nervous. He's pretty and cute.
You are very into the geisha thing, aren't you?
Just wait till you get in here.
So you painted this?
I did, yes. It's very much not finished. All my musical books, all my acting books, whatnot, and my Wicked book.
Yeah, that's on camera, right?
That's fine.
Okay.
He didn't say anything wrong.
Well, I'm just making sure.
He's just in the back of my house.
And crashed into walls.
Hey.
You guys are just taking off?
Yep.
Yep. Fair enough.
Whoa.
Thank you guys for coming.
Okay.
That was awkward. That was awkward.
Oh, you're squeezing too hard.
Yeah, that was a terrible first kiss, and I should have taken that as a hint.
Cody went to give Jonathan a goodbye kiss, and then Jonathan totally just like kind of shut him down, and I secretly kind of was a little bit excited.
He's got a best friend on the phone.
How did Jonathan and Cody even happen? They don't seem to match well.
Yeah, it definitely happened really fast, and I thought it was kind of weird.
See, you and Jonathan make sense. Both nice and cute, whereas it's Cody. Sorry, Cody.
I do think it's weird, but also at the same time, they're not actually dating yet.
Well, Cody did just sort of launch himself on top of Jonathan. It was like a goodbye, whoa!
We were all invited to a big party at Cole's house. Lots of people were there.
Party at Cole's house? That was an interesting night.
Oh my god, it's homo soup!
Told me when I turned the music off, it made me sad.
I did do that. I'm sorry.
And Nick
that.
Told me that it was.
Sorry.
And this is a video game.
Me? Hello.
Chris, really?
Yeah!
You know what? This is important footage.
Yeah.
If I was Chris, I would want this.
Thank you!
There was this random guy there that I don't remember his name, but he was hitting on everyone.
Oh, you're so wrong.
Yeah, I'm with you.
I love you.
Just wasn't good.
My best Jewish friend.
Jesus Christ.
I'm not Jewish. We're just so Jewish together.
Not comfortable.
Mazel tov.
You know that.
Oh, God. He's just too drunk. But I like
him.
Mazel tov.
Some very, very, like, forward, slutty boys that didn't really take the hint that people were there with other guys.
So, Chris, can you smell this?
Scott spilled Southern Comfort on me. No, I can't smell it.
I have lots of money and a large penis! Stop it!
That's my
rap! I think at one point I saw Chris and Jonathan go outside by themselves.
Okay, are you two, like, official now?
We're unofficially official. So. You make a face. What does that mean?
Nothing.
What? You made a face.
No.
You were like...
Apparently they're official now, so I guess that means it's game off for me. Cody is a lot more forceful than me, and he went in there, he got his number, he started texting him. I'm not like that. I'm a lot more standoffish, and so sometimes I miss out because of that.
It's like it's been a week, you know?
It happened really fast, hey?
How long do you need, really?
Well, did you just, like, need him and, like, know?
Basically, Cody added me on Facebook and was, like, chatting with him, and he just asked me on a date, and then went out.
So was he, like, your type? Or was it just his forwardness that, like, got you?
He's definitely forward. Like, when it comes to, like, the gay culture, and, like, I like the more flamboyantly straight, I guess you would consider Cody.
I mean, yeah, it was a little bit annoying, but, I mean, I'll get over it. At some point, you have to put your own feelings aside and be happy for someone else sometimes.
He's so worried. He's like, everyone has to be nice to Jonathan when Jonathan comes around.
No, they don't.
And we're like, Cody, he already likes you.
Hello.
What's up?
Oh, Cody's looking for you.
For me?
Of course he is.
Hey.
Come upstairs.
We will.
No.
Okay,
two of you right now, you are freaking out CN.
It's kind of awkward when you're looking around for your boyfriend for 10 minutes and you don't know where the fuck he is.
He's got he loves me. He loves you not.
Now I have one all the way down my brand new shirt.
I am a party slut.
I'm so over them. There are way too many.
For a second,
DJ and what?
I'm gonna
hey, I hurt myself.
Brandon, smile.
Oh, no way.
What?
Yeah, they were my glasses, but David broke them.
It was very awkward.
Last year, I had lots of drama with Merwin because we weren't seeing each other. It's been about 6 months.
Hey, it's me. I know we haven't talked in a while, but me and Nick are having our birthday thing at the Harvest.
He's the last person I expect to hear from, but I've already made up with Nick, and Merwin calls me, and now, I guess, is our chance to be friends again.
Just wanted to see if you wanted to get together and, like, work things out or talk or whatever, so, because it'd be cool if you could come. So give me a ring back, and we'll go from there.
Been a long time since I've been up this way. How have you been?
Not bad. Having a birthday party. It's crazy. Fucking intense.
The Harvest thing, I heard about that.
Yeah.
Like you and Nick are having a joint birthday or something?
Yep. What about you?
What about me?
Mm-hmm.
I've been good. Yeah, things have been different.
Well, just wanted to say, we should get past all of this, like, crazy crap.
We both just had crazy stuff going on, and then I had my wisdom teeth out, and I was like, where's he when I need it?
Because I didn't know you had them out! Nobody told me shit!
Well, you weren't talking to me. How was I supposed to? Just next time you have a problem, just don't deal with it that way. Just like, let's talk, let's figure it out. And anyhow, I look forward to your birthday.
Better. Well, better be good.
Yeah.
That kind of money.
Anyhow. Yeah, I gotta get going, so I guess.
Alright, well, come here.
So Merwin's back in my life, and along with his close friend, Nola.
You suck, Megan! I'm gonna cry. No, can I go now?
Yeah.
Me?
Hello.
Yay.
It's been a living room.
Absolutely.
You can probably have to go to the living room.
Yeah, let's all play living room. Go.
James! Megan!
Yeah, hi.
James. I'm sorry. I just realized as I was peeing. I don't know why.
Sorry. Oh my god, Megan hasn't met James yet.
So you flip those.
I'm driving.
What?
Yes.
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 What?
Cute.
Give me
a
he's 22.
Okay.
He's a ginger.
He's
pretty old.
Yeah. He's pretty old. Well, he is.
So hot.
Oh, another one you're prowling on.
And apparently he met you and thought you were a giant queen.
But things aren't exactly how they were before. He seems a little bit cold. I still feel like there's residual negative feelings, and I get that a lot from both of them.
Are you videotaping this, you douchebag?
What?
What?
Douchebag.
Yeah. My sentiments exactly, because we don't like videotaped.
We don't need everyone to hear that.
So, Scott got into a fight with his parents, and he ended up wanting to move out. We had a brief little talk about it, and then we decided, why not move out together?
This is not my idea. This is not my idea.
So, we ended up getting a place in Rutland, and it was a small, quaint little place.
Are you gonna cry?
I was crying. I just cheered on the blanket.
I was like, why are you doing this to me?
I was in a lot of pain.
Cause he was suppressing this like horrible blood curdling scream. Like he was trying to be like, ah! But instead he was like, ugh.
Jonathan was telling me about like, apparently people are making a lot of like a glow in the dark lose.
Scott and James moved in. It's cute. The place is nice. And so that spells like a lot of trouble. A lot of drinking. A lot of trouble.
It took me only an hour to move in, to move all my stuff from my house into Ray's car.
You kind of just dumped everything in there, so you didn't really move in.
That's true.
Like, I didn't like live with like a family unit. Like, that just wasn't my style. I did my own thing. I just lived there.
So one night I went, Cody was busy and Jonathan wanted to do something, and I was friends with Jonathan, so we went and saw a movie. Jonathan tells me that he actually liked me when we met, and apparently he thought I didn't like him.
Whatever. Everyone's different when it comes to that kind of shit. I don't know, like, when I first met you, like, I was, like, trying to get to know you and, like, talk to you, and you're just, like, you're really quiet.
I seem standoffish.
Pretty much. But why did you think that? Like, I was trying to, like, I don't know, ask you questions and stuff like that, and I don't know, you just... But I was just kind of like, okay, well... Maybe he's just not interested. That's just really annoying, because I kind of liked you too. Back in the beginning.
Really?
I find that more of a shock. I had no idea. And so I just moved on to, I don't know, other things. AKA Cody. Cody is all in your face, and you're cute.
When we first met, like, he was Cody and, like, flirtatious, and I was just like, you say all the right things at all the right times, like, this is just...
He's really good at what he does.
You know how they say, once you get married, everything changes?
You sound like you're having second thoughts.
I had already accepted the fact that he liked Cody, and I thought Cody's just his type. But apparently, I just didn't make a move. How often does this happen? How often do I like people, and I just don't make the move?
I found out that Scott and James are going to move in together after dating 3 weeks by text message while I was at work, and it was a really nice message to get while you're trying to work and it's really busy.
I don't think it's a bad idea.
At the same time, like, James has to make some mistakes.
There's, like, lots of stuff that could go wrong, but I don't think that they should not move in just because...
Do you think it's a little fast after 3 weeks of dating?
But they're not really looking at it like that.
No.
They have to, though, at the same time.
But maybe they're not, Evan. Maybe that's why you're like, oh, in the 3 weeks of dating, we're gonna get together. Well, maybe they're not looking at it like that, so that's why they're not like, oh, this seems a little bit fast. I'm just gonna go put my chest in real long. We'll find you a new boy.
I want the world. I want the whole world. I want to wrap it all up in my pocket. It's my bar of chocolate!
Me, Scott, and Jake decided to go for lunch, and we were at Earl's, and then Evan and Amelia came up the stairs, so...
Are we doing lunch at the table or separate?
Oh, can we change it? We just want her free.
Okay. We decided, I guess... Why not get a table all together?
That was so weird. That was like from the hills.
I know.
You should see us relay. We were there at John.
I was in Vancouver.
Oh, okay. Well, who parked at the very top? Who are you texting?
Did you? Were you like a server or host or? Oh, that
was birthday. At Boston.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, Jake, are you going to the party?
I think he's meeting Brad.
It's like a service ad. He posted.
Yeah, of course. Yeah,
episode 3 the other day.
We have to take a bus at 9:15.
So let's go that way.
Okay.
It
was a pleasure seeing y'all.
Yeah,
I can't believe that was a coincidence, though.
Yes.
Like that. What?
I don't know.
Okay.
Well,
so. See you later.
See you later.
Bye.
Bye. Have fun. Who's it awkward? I was the first one that walked up the stairs, and I see Jake. I was like, that's weird. And I'm like, who's Jake with? And I was like, I was thinking like, maybe like Nikki P, not a big deal. And I see James, I'm like, oh fuck.
It wasn't, I didn't feel like it was awkward at all.
I felt like it was awkward. Because I came up the stairs, and you guys were like halfway down the stairs still, so none of you were
okay, well, that moment,
like,
but the whole dinner as a whole.
No, that wasn't that bad.
It wasn't bad at all. Wasn't it just yesterday when you were like, I don't like you anymore, and now we're all sitting at dinner together, like
yeah.
A happy little family?
It was awkward. For me, at least.
Freaking gates!
No! That's not no. But I cut myself, I made like a hardwood nose thing at work, and it was really sharp. We're having a good party! We're good!
See, that's okay.
That's what chickens do.
I have no problems. You have no problems. Dinner on Thursday was good.
I never really had any problems.
He's drinking my GHB!
Yeah! It's more faster than I thought it was.
My drinks!
How's it going?
Good, how are you?
Nice to meet you.
Let's buy you
tickets for Nick and Brandon's birthday.
Behind me! Talk to the fabulous Miss Nona!
Hello!
So it's gonna be a big party.
I don't have any money.
So does that
she
does?
I do have
money.
I'll give it to James.
Is it your birthday?
Today, yes.
Happy birthday. I don't know who you are.
I'm
happy.
I'm the hide, apparently. The one that everyone loves to hate. By the way, thank you for that.
So nice.
I have already heard like from five people that I've seen you online. I've been warned to watch out.
You fell asleep, so
you guys should both come.
Go where?
At the Mafia. There's a big party.
Oh, I thought you said I'm going out.
$30 a ticket.
I'm going.
Bye. I miss you.
It was nice meeting you.
Got my new YouTube channel, man.
Come on. I didn't realize it was gonna be like a gay party. I can't.
What was your story about the whole bisexual thing? Like,
story about the bisexual thing. I guess you could say I was lonely, and I couldn't get any girls because they all knew I was a player. So I stayed at my buddy's house, and I'm like, hey, we're alone, and we just watched like an hour of porn, so we're both horny. Why don't we just make out or something? He's like, oh, okay. I thought it was just a one-night thing, and then realized, oh, wait, that actually turned me on. So there you go. I'm bisexual.
Like, how... I don't know. That just seems like a weird way to start. Like, hey, let's just make out, you know?
I'm seriously going to be like, seriously, on my balls. Tripod.
Another drink? Mix
yeah.
yourself. Let's go.
Where's that energy drink?
What's the guy in the white shirt? What's his name again?
Chris.
Chris is such an awesome guy. He actually listens to my story.
Oh.
Like, no, thank you. Had a really nice night, or kind of a nice night. It was a drunken night. Jonathan came out.
He's coming about like half an hour. That's why I haven't actually started drinking yet.
Does he not like you when you're drinking?
You know how they say once you get married, everything changes?
You sound like you're having second thoughts.
Like, one of the main reasons is like, and he was like, when I drink so much. And I'm like, how much? And he's like, blackout drunk. And he like doesn't see a problem with it. And I'm just like, well, can you like kind of hold back a little? If someone says something to me that is gonna be, that they aren't comfortable with, like, you should respect that. And like,
he didn't.
Yeah. So I don't know, like, I wanna talk to him, but.
What's that?
No.
Yeah, yeah. Cody is extremely drunk right now.
Scott, where's Scott? Yeah,
no.
Scott, where's
Scott? Oh my god, yeah!
Yeah!
Yeah, 1990! Yeah!
Dishes at a party because I'm sober.
Thanks.
I'll grab you a pillow.
Drank, we hung out, and then bright and early in the morning, super hungover, he decides to dump me.
So Jonathan came later that evening at the party, and he like made eggs for everybody. The next morning, Cody comes barging in her bedroom, and he says that Jonathan just broke up with him that Mother's Day morning after they were just together the night before. So Cody decided to get day drunk.
Mainly it's just like, I feel bad because I keep thinking I'm ready for like a relationship.
Like, that's nice. You couldn't have just done it the night before so I could have partied it away. You tell me in the morning that you're breaking up with me, and then he's all upset and I'm hungover, so I really don't give a shit. It's like, there was tears in his eyes and, I don't want to break up with you, but I'm going to break up with you. It's like, okay. I'm hungover, I'm just gonna go back inside and start drinking. If you're gonna dump someone, boys and girls, dump them in the night so they can get super hammered and drink it out of their system. Because what I ended up doing was, on Mother's Day, I ended up drinking 2 40s of rum with my friends.
I just said I was really pissed off. Like, the worst part was is that, like, he got so wasted.
and we were like, I was like dancing. He was upset because I was dancing with friends. I was upset because he was dancing with complete strangers. And we were like complete opposite because like he thinks dancing with friends is like too intimate. And I think dancing with complete strangers is too intimate. It's because like you don't know them. And he's like, oh no, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine. I do this all the time.
No, it was I drink too much. I party too much. I'm too wild.
You okay, Cody?
Okay. I'm not gonna be dull, I'm not gonna tame it down. I am who I am. I'm weird, I'm psychotic, I ramble. I'd rather be with someone who accepts me for me than having to alter who I am.
Do you feel bad about Cody? Like, do you feel bad that it went down?
Well, I mainly feel bad because, like, I like to know where I am in life, the point that I'm at right now. I think I know what I want, but I don't know what I want. And it sucks. It sucks on both ends because it sucks for the person that I'm with because, like, I have to tell them, like, look, this isn't working out. It sucks for me because, like, I am not comfortable with myself, and I hate feeling that.
How's he taking it, though?
Cody?
Yeah.
Well,
have you talked to him?
Mm-hmm. I thought he was okay with it. Well, when I broke up with him, he was okay. I was gonna say dumped, and that's horrible. When I broke up with him, he seemed okay with it, but keep in mind, the night before, he got blackout drunk again. So when he woke up, he was still drunk. So I had to, like, redo it all over again.
You had to break up with him again?
Yeah, it was like 2 times. I don't know how he feels right now. Basically, he was upset that I was hanging with you. So
I was talking to one of my exes, my last ex, I guess. And he was kind of upset with me because I'm hanging with Chris, who is one of his good friends, his pride is hurt. Like, tell me if I'm crazy. Chris and I started hanging out. They're not officially, like, dating or, like, seeing each other. Like, we are hanging out a lot, and, like, I don't know.
The general gist of what he was saying, I guess. He just says, so you and Chris, eh? And then he says, have you hooked up with him?
So I'm hanging out with Jonathan, and Cody's texting Jonathan, and apparently he's heard about us, and he is not happy.
He said that I was being a dick, basically. And I was like, I have a soul. I have respect for other people's feelings. I never intended that to happen to you. Like, I told Chris, I was like, I don't really want a commitment right now. I'm not ready for it because I've had past relationships where I've dated the person for like a month. So I don't want the same thing to happen again. Right now, it's just not for me, right?
Says, I'm sorry for being like this, but you guys went to a movie 3 days before the breakup. We had a thing. We had a thing for you before we did. Together. And I said, like, we're always together because you're never there. So, the only words that come to mind are S2, or A2 Brutus. Like, so I'm stabbing you in the back because it's not you, Chris.
So yeah, like a week after I get dumped by Jonathan, Chris ends up going on dates with him. Unfortunately, I didn't actually hear it from him first. You gotta hear it from everyone else that's telling you. I guess, you know, it's good that you get the message that that one of your friends is pretty much dating your ex. A little bit of A2 Brute right there, huh?
I'm just saying what I feel. Plus, I know that Chris constantly plays boys, and even though I know we will be together, I don't want to see you use like so many others.
Sure, I understand and I feel bad, but I can't help but thinking about all the guys Cody has gone with while I was seeing them. A2 Brute indeed.
And I was trying to be like nice about it because he was making me very angry. I don't know. What do you guys think? I was just kind of like, it doesn't really bother me.
But you're coming to the party, right?
The
big one, yeah. Good.
Kamloops, Nick's little brother, is going to DJ for us. I don't know, there's lots of people on it. It's kind of become, like, Nick's domain. I guess it's, like, it's kind of up to Nick.
I'm leaving it up to him. It's supposed to be a birthday, not work.
I'm doing all the goddamn work. It's not even my birthday. No, ask Nick, get people. Start getting people's money.
Fine, I'll start, like, trying to collect. I'll harass people who have said they're coming.
Start getting harassing Nick to start collecting, too.
Yeah.
We need him to get the guests there, because most of these people are his guests.
What a fun party.
Well, it's $6,200 for the venue, just for the harvest. $6,200. I dished out the freaking damage deposit.
I know.
Down payment.
Cody thinks that you're, like, making a move on Jonathan, and, like, the reason, the reasons you broke up is because Jonathan was, like, more interested in you or something. I don't know.
So what does Cody think? Does he think we're, like, hooking up?
Yeah,
it's not like that at all. Like, Jonathan even told me, he's like, that, like, we're just hanging out.
Yeah, I definitely think you should talk to Cody before it gets any worse.
I didn't even know he thought that because he didn't talk to me about it, but
Cody doesn't talk about a lot of things.
Yeah.
He just drinks.
Hey.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi.
Sorry, were you asleep?
Yeah.
It's like 2 in the afternoon.
What's up?
Well, I haven't heard from you in a while, so I just wanted to call and make sure you weren't, like, psycho pissed at me or something, because everyone's been saying stuff about me and Jonathan, which...
Yeah, just for a while, I'm over it.
Okay, well, that's good.
And Chris phoned me and was like, oh no, we're not doing anything. And again, there's that ticking time bomb of, like, okay, till when?
Yeah, I haven't really been doing much, most of the time.
You want to wish them the best, but you also want them to get hit by a truck.
So I'm not even just that party this weekend's gonna be.
I don't know. I'm kind of worried because there's so much buildup. I have.
Well, then it'll probably be packed.
I think it should be, but like, how late does it go till?
I don't know, like 9:30.
I guess that's not bad.
$7,000.
You want to go to somebody's birthday if you actually talk to them? If they don't talk to you for 4 months and they just kind of hide out?
Like, especially for the amount, $30 for a party.
I haven't got, like, a text from either of them for at least 4 months.
Let's buy tickets for Nick and Brandon's birthday.
There's a big party. Oh,
I've already
said I'm going, yeah.
Are you going to the party?
I think he's getting credit.
Yeah, of course.
Hey guys, it's John. So I went to Nick and Brennan's birthday party last night, and I was on the way to Chris's house. So Chris was supposed to be getting with Breezy, and then she calls him, and she's like, ah, Chris. And I was like, she sounds like a biatch. So we go, and we pick her up.
I can't believe you went to the hostel.
Breezy is really nice as well. It's funny, because the girls are like in these like little dresses, and I was like, man, you guys are just going to like a birthday party.
So the harvest party, I went with Jonathan and one of my friends from school.
Dumb shit.
She puts her hair in a side pony.
There. We get to the party.
God. We get to the harvest party and Jonathan, like, takes off, which is fine. Personally, I like to go with people and sort of stay with people. You know, to each his own.
So, the harvest party was big and extravagant and there was a really good turnout.
The amount of money that they paid, it was stupid.
Chris showed up with Jonathan.
Oh, I
didn't do that. Is everyone here?
Everyone at the bar, stop drinking! First of all, we would like to thank Nola. Nola organized this entire thing. And thank you to all of you for coming. We love you all, especially Brandon, he loves you most.
Like a whole bunch of guys were giving out tickets. I think I got 6 free drinks. When you're gonna be hosting a party like that, put someone in charge of liquor tickets that you trust. Don't trust some guy who's gonna give away tickets to everyone who you think you can get a beach from.
Lots of people were really drunk.
Yeah. No, I don't want this anymore. I don't know.
Brody, and I live with Steven.
Nick was a drunk mess. He was falling all over the place.
Go, Vanessa, go.
I went on a little adventure and kind of walked around.
Why are you just like walking all over the place?
What?
You're just like walking all over the place. You can't even. Yeah.
I'm exploring.
Exploring.
Are you taking for Chris?
Yeah, I'll give him to him.
I don't.
Oh, I love often. This waterfall.
It's pretty. That's like crazy. Can you get up for
me? Oh, hotties, 12 o'clock there.
Okay. I love Lady Gaga.
Me too.
Yes. We're soulmates. Is that right? Soulmates. We're going to a concert together.
How old are you?
I'm 17.
Turn off the camera.
And I drove Dan and Chris home. I stayed at Chris's house last night because I was like, I'm so tired. I fell asleep on his couch. So I guess I had to stay the night or else I would have been... I would have probably passed out behind the wheel, and that's never good.
It was a good time. I don't remember much of it. I definitely shouldn't have drank that much. I should still be wearing these glasses. I think I was grinding with both of Merwin's aunts at one point, and there was little snake Evan.
Yesterday, Evan was like reaming out James for like 3 hours about how he's changed, and I'm like poison to James, a bad influence on him.
And they've been broken up for like
six
months.
Time to get the hell
move on. Everyone trash talks now and again, but you gotta put it in small, needle-sharp doses in the gay community. A little quick jab, and then try to smooth it over. When you layer hate on to a whole bunch of people all at once, it ends up making you look like an idiot. Evan, the terrible move that you're always gonna have, like, some special relationship with the first person you had that with.
Fine,
I understand that. I'm not putting up with Evan's bullshit anymore.
I'm not.
So Breezy's actually really nice.
Yeah, I know. That's what I was telling you. And you're just like,
she sounds like a bitch.
Really nice. And then she, like, came up to me and she's like, so you and Chris, eh? And I was like, what? And she just like, oh, you smiled. And she was like, awkward. Yeah. And then at one point, I was so awkward because I was like dancing. And James came up to me and he was like grinding with me. So I was like, can I find some people that I can like actually just kind of hang out with?
And then I hang out with me.
I know, but like I went to go get a camera.
We were standing there for like a couple minutes, and then you just like turned around and booked it like towards the bar, and we were just like, oh. Okay.
I should have said something, but
I guess he's gone.
I thought you guys would have been like chilling there for a second, so I was gonna come back.
But yeah, I'm gonna. Apparently, we're going out for drinks at Boston Pizza tomorrow night with like Cody and them.
However, he's not ready for a relationship.
Why does everyone think you're a player, Chris?
Just because of last year, how I would see a guy, it wouldn't work out, and then I would stop seeing him. And then people would be like, oh, Chris has a new boy every week. You go on a date with someone, doesn't mean you're in a relationship with them. And if they start sleeping with your friends, you're not obligated to keep seeing them. Every single semi-relationship I had with a guy, I can explain exactly what happened, exactly why it ended, and it doesn't make me a player.
I know this is an uncomfortable situation for you, but why did he feel so bad about this after all the history with Cody?
Because it was his boyfriend.
Yeah, but Cody's done this to you in the past.
But not with boyfriends.
Why do you draw this line in the sand about boyfriends?
Because that's what a boyfriend is. That's when it is something. That's when it becomes something. That's when it's like you really connect with someone and they really matter to you.
So Cody would only, you know, sleep with people you might be interested in, but you weren't really boyfriends then.
Yeah.
And that's someone you call a friend.
I mean, it sucked, but it wasn't enough to end our friendship. That was the part that I put up with. In spite of our friendship.
Why?
Okay. So, I'll see you either next weekend or next week.
I'm off next Thursday and Saturday.
Okay.
because the rest of the friendship was good. That wasn't the part that made him a friend. It wasn't enough to break it.
Hey guys, it's John. This is Chris. He is The Valley Days on YouTube. You should check him out. I haven't done a video in a long time, like a couple days, and Chris came over and he was like, we should do a video.
I said we can ham.
He was like, we should do a video. And I was like, okay, let's see. Then we get home. He's like, are we going to have drinks? And I was like, you need to have drinks before you have a video? I don't know.
More fun.
Drinking and making videos is the best way to go, biatches. So I had a party at my house one night, and Cody calls me, and he tells me that he invited Eric.
Which was to get my camera back, but I forgot that he's turned on by that kind of thing.
Let me tell you,
five
people I
invited
to lunch
and
bring a friend.
Who?
Eric.
Yes, Cody. I'm playing nice with Eric. I don't care about Eric. That's still last year. Season one. We're on season two now.
The difference. Here's the difference. She says one, two, three, not only you and me. This one fucking pull out goes, show me where your dick at.
Jonathan showed up and Merwin and I went into my room. And then Merwin tells me that he doesn't want to be in the videos anymore.
Red blind is like period blood.
He's in his bedroom right now. Him and Merwin.
He has a TV show?
He has like 4 or 5 episodes now.
I'm on it.
After all the time filming together, he wants me to take him out of the entire story.
Chris and Merwin, they should stop talking to each other forever. It's like, I'm gonna hang out with you, and then I'll jab a needle into my eye. You wouldn't do that. But unfortunately, you won't stop hanging out with each other.
When we came out of my room, things were tense.
I love the smell of your distillery.
I am actually.
It's just their venom for each other. It's like slowly drinking toxic waste when they hang out.
I could cut the tension then. 10 minutes of footage, 30 minutes of blooper. Okay. So I hear the format of the valley has changed recently. What happened, Chris?
We've run into a bit of a road bump. One of the characters no longer
wishes to be in the show.
He's kind of one of the main characters, and I have a lot of footage of him, which is going to make it hard to cut him out. So I have to figure out a way to cut him out and still explain the story, because there is a story and there's things that happen, and I can't change that because this isn't fake. I just filmed what happened.
Yeah, this is real
life. Do it in like a blog kind of style.
Yeah, I hear you watch video blogs a lot.
I do. I watch. Sorry. You're just so like professional about it. It makes me laugh.
That's a good attitude.
Merwin made it pretty clear to Nick that he didn't like his boyfriend, and thus began the giant rift between friends. We went out for Nick's boyfriend's birthday, and Brad was there. You remember him from season one?
I hate everyone. You're off.
Fuck off. No videos.
Merwin's just a Nelly fucking bitch.
You stay with me? No, then I hate you even more.
Do a shot, Chris.
What is it?
Don't ask.
A prairie fire.
Take it.
Do a shot, Chris. Hey, do a shot. If anyone ever tells you to do a shot and that it's called a prairie fire, run in the opposite direction.
This smells like pickle juice.
Pickle juice, yes, drink it. No, faster.
What the fuck?
For the burn to go away.
No, it gets worse, trust me.
It gets worse.
So John started to seem distant.
We get to the harvest party and Jonathan like takes off, which is fine. Personally, I like to go with people and sort of stay with people.
I went on a little adventure and kind of walked around.
Gotta find some people that I can like actually just kind of hang out with.
And then hang out with me.
I know, but like I went to go get it.
And then you just like turned around and booked it.
So with that on top of the Merwin thing, I was like, fuck this shit. I'm going to the condo with my Vancouver friend.
Oh, well, let's try. But it's not a button. Like these aren't. Oh, they are. They change. What do you think the light's for?
Okay, never mind.
The extra won't go away. There's so much extra.
The wackiest timer I've ever seen.
It's because it's mad, yeah.
I don't know what to do.
You just keep saying it and trying to figure out what the phrase is. Yeah. Apricanalot, a parking lot.
Yeah, yeah.
A hockey player.
Don't stretch this out on my account.
You try this? Are not from frozen lasagna that might kill us with salmonella because it may or may not be cooked fully.
Remember me and Amy were hanging out and we like called you up and we were like, hey, we're drunk.
I do remember that, yes. That was entertaining.
And
my goodness, if only I had recorded that.
and that's when we were all like, hey,
we should
come down.
We should come see you.
Mm-hmm.
And you didn't really mean it, but then it happened. All right, this lasagna is, I think, pretty good.
It was decent. And chicken, not beef.
Thanks for remembering, dear.
You're welcome, sweetie.
We need to never do that again. If that's okay, we just agree on that now.
Who are you talking to?
Ben.
How's Ben?
Ben's good.
Pay attention to me, I'm getting jealous.
Why are you getting jealous?
Because I get jealous.
Of what?
Boys.
It looks like blue raspberry.
Me and Chris got together one afternoon.
What? I hung out with Jonathan yesterday.
That's so random.
We have like a lot of things in common. But
like what? Like anime stuff?
Anime stuff, musical theater.
I just find it funny because he's like, oh yeah, I'm sorry I haven't been able to see you that much. I've just been really busy. And then he comes to Kelowna and hangs out with you, doesn't say a word to me.
Surprise, surprise, Jonathan's been making regular trips to Kelowna and not even saying hi. Sounds like a healthy friendship to me, right? Should I hold off on the wedding ring?
Instead of like avoiding you and not talking to you?
Like if he doesn't want to hang out, that's fine. I just feel like he should tell me.
And we talked about Jonathan's video he posted, and he was talking about, I guess, all of his exes, and briefly talked about Chris, and just said, like, it just didn't work out. And I guess Chris had no idea.
Maybe I'm just being needy. Maybe he really is busy, making a video for YouTube about how much better I am than his ex-lovers. Oh, no? It's the opposite of that?
Hey guys, it's John, and Kyle Kidd has a question for me. It says, how many serious relationships have you had, and in your opinion, do you think that relationships are worth the struggles and the problems, even though they may not work out in the end?
So I start watching this video, thinking, oh, he's talking about his relationships. I wonder what he'll say about me.
I can count them on one hand. There was Brendan, that lasted for 3 years. That ended because he was not very nice to my family. Mackenzie, I dated for a year, and I miss him dearly. There's nothing more I want right now than to have him and to date him again, because I still love him. And I've talked about this with lots of people, my Mac situation. Tons and tons and tons of people. It's not healthy. So then I dated Cody for a month and a half, and he turned out to not be what I expected.
Cody turned out to not be what I expected. God, he has a way with words.
And I was kind of seeing Chris, but we weren't like dating or anything like that, but that wasn't really working out completely. And that's pretty much it. Right now I'm single, and I think it's best to be single for a while. Gotta wait for the perfect one, right? You gotta wait for the perfect one.
Sorry, just let me get this knife out of my gut, which, incidentally, I just pulled out of Cody's back.
So you watched that video that I talked to you about?
Yeah, yes. You told me about it that day, and I went and watched it that night, and I was like, oh. He's like, yeah, Chris and I were seeing each other, but we didn't really work out. But the thing is, he didn't even tell me when it was over. He just kind of stopped talking to me.
Yeah.
I'm kind of the person that needs to know that.
Here's a tip. Hey, if we're not seeing each other anymore, might be nice to let me know that.
I'm not going to talk to you.
I'm not going to tell
you.
You. I'm not going to tell you that it's done.
Tell you when I'm in town.
And I'm going to tell other people not to tell you because I don't want conflict.
Oh, you don't like conflict? That sounds like a good excuse to avoid responsibility.
Well, it's going to make more conflict when I find out from YouTube instead of you.
Kids, here's another tip you won't get from Twilight. If someone seems like they're being distant, they probably are.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Hi.
Ugh, what's up?
Oh my god, I'm so tired.
Sound cold?
Yeah, I guess because I just woke up and now I'm sitting in a car.
To warm places.
Well, I would if you didn't work till 4:30 in the morning. I just don't get why it changed from, like, the first couple weeks.
As usual, there's been a couple of really big things going on, but...
I know, but it's just, you went from, like, texting every day, and now it's hard-pressed to, you know, text you once a week.
No, I hear you, and that's not fair. I apologize for that.
If you don't want to, you don't want to. It's not really a fair thing, but...
I don't know. I guess I can't say much except I'll try harder.
I was actually, I had connections to get in, but...
Ooh, you have connections to get in,
not
too.
Not anymore.
Not anymore, sweetie.
Yeah, Nola said they'll probably come after they're done watching their movie.
Who?
Perfect.
What?
Some Nolan Brody? Check.
Nola, Brody, and Merwin.
Oh, Merwin.
Just a clusterfuck of fuck.
It's pretty sucky when you lose all of the people that you're closest to all at the same time. Seems like a lot to deal with. So it's a good thing that while you're dealing with that, you don't have to deal with awkward run-ins from people who used to be your friend who have formed groups of people who now hate you for no reason. Oh, wait.
I don't really have anything against Merwin.
Jay's great thing, or
I have something against what he does.
12:25 thing.
Like, all that shit with the valley, like, oh yeah, I'll be on it, blah, blah, blah. And then he just, like, makes it, and then he's like, I won't be on it, take me off.
Just to piss Chris off.
He's done that, like, four times now.
Seven.
Getting played out. I'm like, seriously, get over it.
Are
you
on
it, or you're not?
So Merwin's coming over with Nola and Brody.
Apparently Merwin's coming over.
I'm Nola.
Brody used to be my friend.
So I'm Brody, and yeah, I live with Steven, and it's interesting.
He gave me that hat I was wearing a while ago. I didn't know that he was Team Merwin now, till he marched in, grabbed the hat off my head, and left. I was so mad that I slammed the door behind them, and that thump you hear, I later found out was not the door hitting Merwin on the foot. Apparently, I'd slammed the door on Merwin's finger.
Here's the fucked up girl.
Sweetie, the fucked up girl left like an hour ago, and her name's Merwin. Just saying.
Oh my god, can you just talk about that for a second?
Okay, what about it? He's very sheltered. And we were seeing each other for a while, and then he went crazy. Over the past year, he's gone completely crazy.
Okay, but, there are so many different forms of crazy.
Okay, I'll explain to you. First of all, every time he talks to me, he freaks out. He's like, oh yeah, let's be friends, let's fix this, let's make it work. But then he freaks out at me for like an hour over text. And one time, he was like, you're not putting any effort into our friendship, we're done, blah, 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 blah. And he's like, oh, but while you're downtown, can you give us a ride to Kevin's house? Like, that's how crazy he is.
Able to get past that. So like, even the fact that he's an only child, he's never had siblings, he's never had anybody to guide him through life, tell him what's bad, what's good, what's right, what's wrong, you know? Besides his parents, which is, like, completely different, because they grew up in a different era, right? You gotta understand that. You know what I mean? It's just, like, how people are raised and how people grow up. It's just, like, it totally affects them. And, yeah, he might be crazy to you, but, like, he is just figuring out his life. I can guarantee it. He's just figuring out what the fuck happened to me.
It's just gone. Like, while he's friends with Nola and Brody, they're enabling him to be what he is, and... it's not going to get any better.
Okay, well, maybe he's not being what he is, but as like the longer he's not who he is, the stronger he'll become himself later.
Okay. What's going on out there?
Let's go do something.
I'm Navin. I knew Megan. And she said, come out, meet my gay friends. And I was like, okay. She got me an invitation to Nick and Merwin's birthday party at the Harvest. And then I had a drink ticket. And then I saw Chris, and I was like, hello. I went up to him offering to trade it for a kiss or something. I had a lot of new people to get to know, so I decided to have my friends over, so I had a bunch of you guys over one night.
Yeah. Does it have to stay in the club? Does it have to stay there?
No, it doesn't. We just don't use any of this stuff. See, I don't know how this works.
And then you can go.
Oh no, I played that. There we go. I knew that was good.
Okay, you know that white hat I had at Brody's? I mean, he saw me wear it out. He pretty much gave it to me, right? So I have had it for like a long time now, and they all showed up.
No, Scott invited Merwin. That's who it was. Scott's like, I'm friends with both of them or something like that, and I'm not gonna like pick sides.
Tonight we're partying at Navid's house, and there's some new guys.
Nathan, we're gonna play a game. Come in.
Yes.
Have you ever done anything? Have you ever been with, like, last question, anyone you cannot stand? Absolutely.
And that's the night I met Scott and James.
How are you?
Good,
how are you?
How are you doing? Nice.
Hey, Jake.
How's it
going? Hey, James! His pants are off!
So, Navid, I have heard from a couple times from Megan, and then Scott was invited to a party at his house, so we went.
Oh, hey! How do you know all you? I've said that more times.
First time I met James, we didn't really talk very much. He kind of sat there being really cool. And I was just kind of awestruck. Who is this creature in my home that is too cool? I can't believe he's here. Like, he's cool. Too cool for my house.
Because it was truth or dare. That's why Navid's not wearing pants.
And we played some truth or dare, and it told us to do some weird things.
This night got really hoary.
Stomach? No, so how's it going, Scott?
Not bad. My groin is getting wet.
And yeah, that's also how I met Jake, or the night I met Jake.
Jake, semi-recently come out as a homosexual. I think he's gonna be a little slutty, maybe. We'll see.
Nice body.
3 seconds, just hold it like that.
What?
And you feel a weird sensation in the back of your throat. Just do it for 30 seconds.
You're shitting me.
No, actually, just do it.
Yeah.
Nice stuff. It's nice.
There we go.
Jake, do a dance for the camera.
I don't dance.
Do a dance.
I don't dance.
Like, I had to give Jake a hickey on his boot.
Where's the hickey going? This is horrible porn music.
Why is everyone watching?
Because that's the point of this game.
How's that?
Nope,
we have done. Yeah. Oh yeah, I think you got it. I think you got it. Oh god, I think you got it, Navid.
Oh baby.
Yeah. That's called balls deep.
Chris went into a bedroom and saw Jake naked.
Choose one other player. Take this player into a private room and completely disrobe in front of them.
I kind of want to look at Chris because that'd be so uncomfortable for him.
I didn't ask for it, but if I have to see him naked.
You're welcome, Chris. I brought him here.
If a hot naked guy's in front of you, you're gonna cop a feel of his butt. I touched his butt.
This is gonna wow.
Chris is getting touchy.
Oh, yeah, it's boner going
out.
Okay.
I'm just covering myself because, you know.
Not because I have a bone or anything. But you were the... Oh, I'm just kidding. I could have
exposed you. Next up, Vancouver Pride. Me and the whole gang planned a trip down to Vancouver for a weekend of lecherous partying.
You take for fucking ever.
What's up, Chris?
Hi.
Sorry. I hate you so much right now. Get in my car.
Hey, I'm Nathan. I've been hanging out with the boys for a few months now. Yeah, so this is the first year that I've gone to a Pride in Vancouver. I'm pretty excited to... see what was gonna happen.
Okay. Can you tell Cody to text me Aaron's phone number? I he can't see us.
We also did pass by Navid, who was not out of the closet to his parents and was driving them to Vancouver while he was going to Pride.
Navid!
So here's what happened the first night. Everyone got shit-faced and no one met up like we planned.
Why was it bad?
We got downtown and Nathan was really, really drunk.
So I hear.
So we kind of like had to do something with him.
Mine was shitty too.
And then I went to the Odyssey and stood in line for like half an hour and I had to pee. And then fucking, okay, I ran into...
Will's boyfriend, and then I saw Will, and then standing there in the line, like, usually I don't have to stand in line, but since neither of you are talking to me, I have to stand in line. And then everyone left, and I left, and then I ran into you and everything.
And now...
Yeah.
Let's go inside.
Josh is...
Looks at me and he's like, aren't you fucking straight? And I look at him, I'm like, what? And he just like turned around and walked away.
Yeah, what the hell happened to you on Friday? All I see is you trailing behind Scott, like walking down the street.
Dude, I don't even remember.
Did you get hooking up with people? Did you hook up with that dude that we saw when you picked up when I picked you up?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
So you randomly went home to somebody that you met yesterday and
Chris doesn't hook up with
yeah. We were friends. He's funny and witty.
You should wear a sign that says I don't hook up with people.
We're trying to board a boat without tickets nor ID. But hopefully the ticket thing can be rectified shortly. The gays are arriving. I believe it's the celebrity gays. May appear on my left quite soon. Here we go. Looking fabulous as always.
In a material world, and I am a material girl.
Anything else eventful happened this weekend? Nick?
I got hurt.
What?
I got hurt.
Like, physically?
Turns out the guy I liked was playing more than one hand of cards.
At the parade anyways.
Me?
Yeah.
I went by myself. I didn't go with anybody.
Oh.
I was just walking around. And then like the Odyssey float was like the very last one. Pride, Navid and Nikki got a little and on the way back from Vancouver driving in the car, Nikki P told us all about it. Now Navid's got a big old man crush on Nikki P.
Navid's all bright-eyed after Nikki. Yeah, Nikki is just Nikki.
It's been a while since I first met everyone, and I can now say that there are some things you have to go through when you're a new gay. There are some times when you're going to be feel like you're being pushed around in the dirt, or heartbroken, or you fall in love with the wrong guy. As you know, I was stupidly crushing on Nikki P.
I don't know, like, I like the guy, but not like that.
Yeah.
He's cool, like, I like his sense of humor and shit. But, like, we were hanging out all day, you know, it was like, kind of like becoming friends, and then, like, making out at the end of the night. It was like, yeah.
It happens.
So while we were decorating, Navid asked me to stop hitting on Nikki P, which I do subconsciously. Me and Nikki are just friendly like that. It doesn't mean anything.
And that's when I knew Navid was in deep. He's got it bad.
I don't mean to sound like a douchebag, but can you do me a favor and not to mack on Nick tonight?
And you would mack on Nick.
Sometimes. I don't know.
Well, shit, I don't remember.
At the after party.
I have no memory of that. But I'm sorry if it did. I totally don't mean to.
You did.
I didn't even know you liked Nick, man. Come on.
I thought you did.
No, I wouldn't be a dick and just like,
why?
Wow.
I didn't know. That's why I was so shocked.
Are you still like into him?
No.
No? Yeah, you are.
No.
Don't lie to me.
Chris had a party. It was right around the last day I was in Kelowna before I went back to school.
This is probably the last party I'm going to have at my house for the summer, and so it's kind of bittersweet. Little did I know it would be one of the most tension-filled parties that I've ever had.
Oh, Zach Chatham! Oh, is this when I came with Jonathan?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I need a fucking drink. There's too many people here I don't fucking like.
There's this whole tension area right here. Eric started... I think Eric was throwing the blunt.
Yeah.
So things were kind of weird for... Weird between Scott and James and Brad. And who walks in the door? Well, Brad. The record scratched, and everyone was like,
I can't wait to see what the joke is in the next one.
Brad is still a fucking shit weasel. People give him shot after shot, and he just ends up shooting himself in the fucking foot.
Did you see who just arrived?
Yeah, that's what I did.
We're Brad.
Yes.
Hi, Brad. Brad's here. Put your pants on.
Basically how it worked.
He, let's just say he did. No, I don't want to say he did something. He did something. You know what you did. I don't want to know that fucking hills. And he showed up at a party where no one really wanted him. He just kind of guilted Chris into getting him an invite. Yeah, he's one of those guys who you would not trust them alone in a room with your boyfriend.
No one really wants to talk about it, but I'm just gonna say it. Brad tried to hook up with James, who is Scott's boyfriend. So the story goes, James was really drunk, and Brad got him alone and tried to make things happen. I don't know how far things went, but it's really shady since Brad is friends with Scott, and now he's coming to my party where a lot of people are not too happy with him. Least of all, Cody.
Oh, okay.
You're sober, Cody.
Oh, kind of like schnapps, that's what.
It is schnapps. That's the original maker of schnapps.
Or I could have shot it. Yeah.
Taste it.
And one big boom. Pieces of 2x4 in the lot right beside water escapes.
I didn't get it either.
Where's my alcohol?
Hey, left it on the table.
Oh, yeah. The one that you guys kept
telling
me.
Yes, I know.
I
just
wanted to see you.
Hi.
Okay. Now you're being weird.
Surrounded by...
I haven't seen Amy since the Winter Olympics. That's how long it's been.
Because, like, I haven't been going out because I'm trying to save money and all that jazz. So I was like, well, nobody's been clubbing, therefore I don't have to spend money on
neither.
That. No, I would have gone out, but my hair today took me, like, 2 hours to make it straight like this, and I really didn't have time to do it, and then I was mad.
Yeah, does he know to avoid me? Because if he comes around me,
I'm going to
talk to you. Bust a ball sack.
He's being all quiet, like,
yeah.
Well, he shouldn't.
He shouldn't fucking come out tonight. If you know that there's gonna be everyone there that you, like, is not happy with you, don't show up. Don't show up just to cause drama.
You should be coming out if you, like, really hurt one of your really good friends who's gonna be there.
She'd be like, hey, maybe you know what I should do? Suck it up and take one for the team, and hopefully they will have enough fun times that they might be able to forget. Okay, who is coming that we actually like still?
As you know, around that time, I had fallen like an idiot for Nikki P. So we were supposed to go out for drinks before Chris's party, because I asked him to kind of go out with me, because I was a little bit of a desperate idiot. But instead, he pulled up, and he had another boy with him.
Go. Get out of my car. Yeah, Nikki is just Nikki. So he kind of brought another guy there. Poor Navid. You make great decisions.
They're very Caucasian. Asian.
I'm a nice girl.
You know what they say, Asian with a cock, Caucasian. They don't actually say that. I think
they were like kissing and nuzzling, and I was like, I'm having a great time.
No, it's so nice to see people and socialize.
It's so nice to see you.
And not just, like, type to people.
You look so different now.
I know. Because when we were in Vancouver, and every time we got really drunk, then we got lost, and we were drunk.
Yeah.
You have that video footage, right?
Amy! Amy, don't fall over!
What happened?
No. Did we go the wrong way?
No. Yeah, we did. We have to go back that way.
Was it your fault?
Yeah, you gave it to me, remember?
Yeah, are you going to use it? Because yep. I really want you to.
Yeah, of course I'm going to use it.
And then Nick and the other boy were being quite cozy.
In the room with your personality.
Yeah.
Well, maybe Tyler. I don't know. Tyler's so translucent, I think he just trumps it.
Tyler, I mean.
Was he even fun?
Hey. Navid was making a fool of himself in front of Nikki P. It's not fun to watch the person that you like make out with someone else.
I
get mean,
and then I start crying.
Alex, do I get mean when I get drunk?
Yep.
Yeah.
And I felt bad because I've been in that exact same position. The first guy I ever had a huge thing for years ago was this guy named Gabriel, and we saw each other for a little while, and I kind of thought that he felt the same way about me until he slept with all my friends.
I don't know what they're doing. Who's that?
Oh my god.
Hey!
Oh, and he just walked through the door.
Oh. Hello.
Oh, okay.
Can I let go of this now? Letting go.
What? As if this party didn't have enough tension, now Gabriel's here.
Whoa. Hey. Pandosi?
Gabriel. What about it?
I'm gonna be on camera. I always say stupid things, so I might as well make myself look like a jackass instead of anybody else.
I have the camera.
Then Scott and James arrived. And I don't think they knew Brad was going to be there. It was super ox. Word. Awkward.
I can't be straight on.
How are you?
I'm staying on.
It's like, I'm not.
What do you do when someone you have history with shows up unexpectedly and you don't want them to see how shaken you are? Put a big smile on your face, march out there, and act like the biggest fake dumb bitch you can possibly be. Oh my god, I'm so glad you're here. I can't believe it. Oh my god, OMG. Oh, and there's the laugh. Ah, you're so funny. Oh my god, I wanna kill myself.
Nick and Colton out in the kitchen making out, and we're all upset, / pissed off, / angry, / kind of horny.
No!
Kind of horny.
Yes, that.
Yeah, okay. So I thought.
Always.
I told you not to like Nick.
I like your jacket, by the way.
Which one? Many people told me that.
Oh my god!
I'm gonna find you!
So I had a little moment, or I snapped with Nikki, where I was too drunk, and I was at the end of my rope, and had a bunch of liquor. And then I just forced myself upon him, made out with him, and then slapped him again and ran away giggling.
Oh, there's the Johnny Beale!
Johnny just
yeah.
wanted to...
Johnny
just woke
up! We're just passing the way. You guys are gonna go
live. Did you force yourself upon him? Or did he force himself upon
you? I forced myself upon him. But he wasn't up for it. We're fixing a problem.
Lauren,
are you okay?
You seen with Colton?
No. I mean, it's like a little... Instead of being a stab in the heart, it's like a splinter.
What should I do?
Just don't think about Nick for the rest of the night.
I don't really, like... It's funny, because when I'm drunk, I usually care more, but right now, with this drunk state, I don't care at all.
Good, then don't care, then let's just go.
And
then it'll be all good. Yeah, exactly. I think someone just rang the doorbell, let's go.
That's so many things to say, I'm just not going to say them.
Say them!
Carrie Underwood before he cheats. Brad has the balls to be singing this right now.
Let's face it, no one here really actually likes Brad. You fuck Chris over.
Ooh,
okay. Scott was the only one, and they fuck Scott over, so is anyone else gonna trust him? No.
Oh my god, he's gonna get his ass kicked.
I'm gonna get fucking toe out of dress. Oh, it's going.
Oh my god!
Shoot at you.
Please,
at the camera.
Please do. No, don't. So later, everybody's gone home.
Whoa, corkscrews and stuff. That's like dangerous items. No, no touching. Okay, be a good boy.
Evan, you have me. That's what
no,
I'm for.
I want one.
Bye, Nick.
Bye,
buddy.
Yeah, it's weird.
Oh,
it's
Cody's still here?
Woo!
Yeah, try finding.
It was kind of sad thinking that a lot of these people we wouldn't see again. And it was a good wrap up to the summer, though.
Hello.
Hi.
What's up?
What?
Are you bummed about Nick?
I haven't seen him for a while, doesn't it?
Well, yeah, you're going back to Vancouver.
You can say bye. I don't care, but. What up? So just. Now I know.
I don't think that's a personal thing. I think that's just how he is. There's tons out there. And you're going to Vancouver. There's tons in Vancouver.
I'm not going to look at people in Vancouver.
No?
No. 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 They're crazy there. And then, like, my second last day here, I basically fuck it up. I'm just like, oh, it's. Perfect.
Hey, Cody.
We
want that.
Forget.
Wow.
The people that have the love will definitely spread it.
Who do you love the most pregnant?
You. A lot of girls and gay guys will automatically say that they love you because they expect that you will love them.
Oh my god, you're gay? Let's be friends.
There we go.
I love you guys. I love all the gay boys. As much drama as you guys have.
As much problems as we've had.
All the drama that you guys have, I still love each and every one of you. If people take their separate ways because of drama, that's what it's supposed to be.
In the end, it all works out.
That night I saw Jonathan's Facebook status set to in a relationship.
I'm just not completely comfortable with relationships right now. Like, I told Chris, I was like, I don't really want a commitment right now. I'm not ready for it.
I guess the lesson is don't believe what boys say. Or maybe it's just that boys don't know what they want. Navid went back to Vancouver. No word on if he ever found a boy or not. Scott and Evan finally made peace.
I'm so happy.
Why?
Because Scott and I made amends.
Well, nah, probably not. Nick and his boyfriend broke up, and I was the only one there for him since he wasn't friends with Merwin anymore either. Amy was still nowhere to be seen. As for me, I never really heard from Jonathan again, or my Vancouver friend. I spent the next couple months battling YouTube infringement notices from Merwin.
Marlin filed a privacy complaint, and YouTube reviewed it. I will use a friggin' sock puppet if I have to, and I'll call it Billy Bob the Third, but I will tell this story.
It didn't look like we would ever be friends again. I did get some closure, though. I unexpectedly hung out with Gabriel.
My life's going pretty good. I'm enjoying it.
What's new? What's interesting? What's abnormal?
Nothing really. But I've never had a Kelowna summer. So
definitely better than the winters.
Stop fidgeting. You're fidgeting too.
But I'm not as noisy about it. I'm not like... It's so random. I haven't seen you in like 2 years.
I know. Well, I felt bad. Like, I didn't see you at all last year.
Yeah.
I always didn't like how we ended off.
You were what?
I didn't like how we ended off.
Or is that why you didn't talk to me last year?
I don't even remember anymore. It's good that we're talking again.
It's a start. Why did we end off the way we did?
I don't know. It's just what happens.
Just what happens in what?
In life. Basically. Yeah, there's lots of times that people should talk and they don't. That's probably what happened.
Spill it. What happened with Gabriel? What was the gist of things?
Yeah, that was weird. We ended up just going to his place.
What did you do? Did you drink?
Yeah, we drank.
So what did you go there looking to get out of it?
I don't know. See what I felt. He was nice. And that makes it suck so much more. In my head, I've learned to deal with it like it's this big bad memory and he's like this like shitty person that did all this shitty stuff. And it's like, now I found out it's just like a regular person.
We'll just go away from it feeling like it's over, it's done, and you don't have to hate him anymore.
But it's almost like I need to hate him to know how to deal with it.
You'll always have a special feelings for the person you're first interested in. It can be a douchebag. You grow from that experience. At least you got to him before he slept with all your friends.
Yeah.
Just because he's, like, not a horrible person doesn't mean he wasn't a horrible person to you at the time. Well, men like sex. And it's not very hard for men to have sex. Or, like, it doesn't have to be romantic. It can just be a good fuck.
And we never had sex. And we laid under a blanket at the beach in the middle of the night and drank hot chocolate. One day we were walking and he gave me his jacket because I was cold, and it's like, all of that is nothing.
You don't think the same way as most gay boys. You're morally a little bit sharper than the rest of us. Don't overthink things, Chris. A, you'll lose your hair. You lose all your power, because we know your power's in your hair. It's gotta be. You're like Samson, except gay.
I wish I could leave you on a better note, but the thing I've realized about life is you don't get a happy ending, and you don't get a sad ending. It just keeps going.